Is it a supply? Yes, it is a supply. And the moment I say it is a supply, is it taxable? Yes, it is taxable. But then you will say, sir, there is no consideration. In valuation chapter, we will determine fair market value, open market value of this commodity, and we will take tax on that. But it is taxable. Donating your office laptop is also taxable. You as a business have to pay tax over it. Why? Because you have taken what? ITC. With what hope we have given you ITC? You will use this laptop to run your business and you will generate business. On that business you will pay tax. But right now shamelessly you are donating that office laptop. That's the problem with us. If ITC was not taken, then? And if you donate, then? No problem. I'll give you one more example. Okay, this is your shop. You sell jeans. Okay, you are selling garments and jeans. Okay, and your brother-in-law came to your shop. Okay, so this is your brother-in-law and this is normal customer. Normal customer bought jeans for 4,000 rupees. Will you take GST from him? Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. So on that, the jeans that you have given to your customer, and there will be input tax credit available, yes or no?
Yes.
And you will pay output tax also. There is the input tax available, output tax you will set up and you will pay. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, brother-in-law is also taking one jeans. Will you charge consideration from him?
No.
No, if you charge consideration from him, brother-in-law will talk to his sister.
Yeah.
And his sister is your
wife.
And your wife will beat you at home.
Yes.
How could you take money from my brother? Yes or no? So you are giving jeans to your brother-in-law for free.
For free.
Government have problem for this. Why? You have taken what?
ITC.
That is a business stock, no?
Yes.
That was available for sale. You cannot just distribute as a fee. Because you have taken ITC, we have hope that you will sell it in the market and you will generate tax revenue.
Yes.
Okay? If brother-in-law comes to your house, opens your cupboard and takes your jeans,
no problem
with government. Why?
No.
On that jeans you have not taken
ITC.
Are you getting this?
Yes.
So permanent transfer or disposal of only business asset, not personal asset. If you transfer personal asset, government doesn't mind it. If you transfer business asset, then only government have problem because you have taken ITC on it. The whole game of Schedule 1 is on ITC. If you understand ITC, Schedule 1 is nothing for us.
Yes.
Hello? Can I go ahead with this?
Yes.
Okay. Second is transfer of business asset for personal purpose. I told you this. We will purchase asset in business and then we will transfer secretly to personal purpose. Am I clear? Yeah. Then one more doubt you may ask, sir, how government will come to know about this? Obviously after inquiry and all. Okay, you cannot ask me that question that, sir, GST department will never come to know about this, that I have taken laptop to my home, I have installed AC to my home. It's not like that. If GST department person comes now and if you count AC, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, only 5 ACs are here, but in balance sheet you are 8 ACs are there. Where are those 3 ACs? That time I have to justify them. So 3 ACs are at home. Oh, then you have done something wrong. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. So obviously this will be revealed only after proper inquiry from department. And department is doing their job. They are reading certain OCC whenever they feel. Like as a chartered accountant, how many laptop I will have in my business?
1, 2, 3, 5.
What if every month I am buying 20 laptops and is it reasonable?
No.
Why am I doing that? I am buying laptop, taking input tax credit, giving it to my friends and all. You want offer, you want discount, it's like that. Yes or no? Right now, if you purchase mobile, say let's take this OnePlus 7, 45,000 plus GST you will purchase?
Yes.
So 45,000 plus 10,000 GST you are going to pay. So for you cost is 55,000, for me cost is only 45,000 because 10,000 I will get as the input tax credit. So you will come to me, sir, will you please buy phone? Likewise, your friend also came, you understand?
Yes.
Likewise, 50 student came in this month, I had purchased 50 phone. Government will have some suspicious about my transaction. They will send me notice, justify the transaction. Where are those 50 phone? I may not be able to show those 50 phone. I may not be able to justify the transaction.
Yes.
Then only this will happen. That is practical issues. But I told you, this is a law. So we have to create law for all things. No. We know that people will manipulate. That doesn't mean we should keep law open. This is anti-manipulation, anti-tax evasion mechanism of GST department. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Okay, can I go ahead?
Yes.
Now second one is related. I told you yesterday also, whenever there is a relation in business, there is a possibility of manipulation. Whenever there is a relation involved in the business, there is a possibility of manipulation. Am I clear? Now one more point before you understand this, you need to get it from registration chapter. GST is a state based law. GST is a state based law. If you are doing business in 5 states, you should get 5 different registration. Hello?
Yes.
Because CGST and?
Yes.
Right now I am doing business only in Maharashtra. So I need only one registration.
Yes.
Maharashtra GST and Central GST. So Central GST is common in all states. But if I open branch in Gujarat, so I have to take one more registration. Gujarat GST and Central GST. Central GST is already there. Hello.
Yes.
Likewise, if I have open business in Kerala, I have to take Kerala GST. So GST registration is a state based. Okay, it's not one registration for one nation. No. It's one registration for one state. One registration for? So for us, this is the understanding. Apart from that, once it is registered, please understand, once it is? So Maharashtra branch and Gujarat branch, branch belongs to me only, right?
Yes.
Legally, I am one entity. You understand single entity concept? Both branches are my branches only, so legally I am registered. Legally I am registered in Maharashtra as well as in Gujarat. According to your understanding of company law, this is the only one company, only two different branches. As per GST law, every registered person is a separate entity. Every registered person is a separate entity. So Maharashtra branch and Gujarat branch are the separate entity. Yes or no?
Yes.
So if I'm transferring my goods from Maharashtra is like production department, to Gujarat, okay, did I sell goods?
No,
it is just a branch transfer. It's just a
branch.
Are you getting this? This is just a branch transfer, one branch to another branch. So there should be GST or there should not be any GST on this transaction? Logically there should not be any GST because there is no consideration also. Why? It is just a branch transfer. Hello. Alright, but government is charging GST on that. Why? First, do you understand problem?
Yes.
Now I'm telling you, government is charging GST on that because now GST is a destination based tax, I told you.
Yes.
Now which branch will sell these goods?
Gujarat.
Alright, that means output tax liability will generate in which state?
Gujarat.
Yes or no?
Yes.
And raw material of these goods, I purchase these goods in which state?
Maharashtra.
Are you getting? So ITC is available in Maharashtra and output tax liability is generating in Gujarat, and I cannot set up Maharashtra credit with Gujarat liability.
Yes.
Hello. So this credit has to be moved from Maharashtra to Gujarat. Therefore government is charging tax on it. The purpose of charging tax here is not punishing you. Actually they are helping you by taking tax. Why? Because if they don't tax this, the credit will remain in Maharashtra and liability will be generated in
Gujarat.
So they are moving this credit. Why? Because Maharashtra branch will pay tax. The moment Maharashtra branch pay tax, Gujarat branch will take credit.
Yes.
Hello. On the branch transfer, Maharashtra will pay tax.
Yes.
Gujarat branch will immediately take ITC, and when Gujarat branch sells it in the market, they can set up and pay only net tax.
Yes.
Are you getting?
Yes.
So this is the purpose for stock transfer or
branch transfer.
Am I clear? Yes. Distinct person means we are assuming them as a distinct person. Hello?
Yes.
They are not actual distinct person. Actually they are same person. Hello? Actually they are same person. So my entity is there in Sri Lanka and I'm in India. My own entity, my holding company is there in Sri Lanka and I'm here in as a branch office or agency office. Technically we are same entity, yes or no?
Yes.
Legally from Companies Act perspective we are same entity, but here they treat us as distinct person, separate person. Am I clear?
Yes.
Okay, so same law, branch to HO. Okay, related person, transaction with related person. Whenever we do transaction with related person, our sale price is not taken into consideration. Why? Because if I have to manipulate, just try to understand this. What is the fair market value of one marker in market?
20
rupees minimum.
Yes.
I'm selling it at 2 rupees to my wife. Only 2 rupees.
Yes.
Because if I sell it for 20, I have to GSP Say I bought it for 15 rupees, 1.5. 15 rupees I bought. So I got ITC on 15 rupees.
Yes,
yes or no?
Yes.
20 rupees I was supposed to sell, but I'm selling only at 2 rupees. And why 2 rupees? I'm giving it for free. I'm giving my markers to my wife for free. Supply without consideration. Hello?
Yes.
Will there be output tax?
No.
But I have taken?
Yes.
I have taken input tax credit? Yes or no? Who will sell these goods in market? My wife will say. Then you say, sir, but my wife will pay tax. No, she will not pay tax. Because in Maharashtra, up to 40 lakh, there is an exemption limit. That means up to 40 lakh of supply, you don't have to pay GST, you don't have to take GST registration. Hello? Are you getting this? One member in the family is registered. Take me as a registered person. I am registered person. So all raw material or purchase item I will do. Because I am in business class, I will get all credits. Why government have given me credit? So that I should sell it in the market.
Yes.
And pay output tax. What smartness I am doing here is this. I have taken all input tax credit and I am giving this marker to my wife for free of cost. That means there is no output tax. I have taken input tax, but there is no output tax.
Yes.
Now who will sell it in the market? Wife. But wife is not registered. Wife is not?
Yes.
So she will not pay GST, output GST.
Yes.
Up to 40 lakh there is an exemption. So then after 40 lakh you have to pay. No, after 40 lakh I will give marker to my mother, then to my brother, hello, then to my son, grandson. Are you getting?
Yes.
I will use all family members to evade
tax.
Yes or no? Therefore government says whenever you are transferring goods to related party without consideration, we will consider it as a supply. And the moment they consider as a supply, now if I give 40 lakh rupees marker to my wife for free, I have to pay tax on 40 lakh. Why is it done so?
Yes.
To control
tax evasion.
Otherwise, there is simple tax evasion, no?
Yes.
Do you understand tax evasion first?
Yes.
Because this is anti-tax evasion. How to evade tax? One member from a family should take registration. He should buy all items. He should take input tax credit. Then he should distribute that goods to 5 different people in the family who are unregistered, because you can remain unregistered up to 40 lakh rupees and then they will never pay. There won't be any output tax liability, but you have taken input tax credit. This is the manipulation that people have done. Okay, to control that manipulation, this is the anti-evasion clause. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Samjha tumko pakka? Tax ki chori nahi hone ke liye aisa hua hai. Okay? Yeah? Aage chalte. Okay, one more point. This may come in as a multiple choice question. First time ever in the history of definition of relatives, employer and employee is also included. First time. Usually laws, tax laws don't consider employee as a related party. First time in the history of any taxation law, employee is considered as a related party. First of all, first thing you should keep that in mind. Employer and employee are related parties. Employer and employee are
related.
Now Diwali just happened in Mumbai. Alright. If I'm a manufacturer of TV, I'm Onida or Videocon or Samsung. We manufacture TV and you all are employees of my company. Alright. I wanted to give you all Diwali gift. Should I give you Diwali gift?
No.
Yes or no?
Yes.
You are all my employees, manufacturing division. I wanted to give you all that smart TV. Everyone will get one smart TV today. You happy?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
But government have problem.
Yes.
What problem government have? If I manufacture TV, I must have taken ITC on that raw material and labor and other activities. Yes or no? With what hope government have given me ITC?
Yes.
I should sell this in market. But instead of selling this in market and creating output tax GST,
yes.
I am giving it as a free to my staff.
Yes.
Government says, sir, this is not right, sir. This should be taxable. This should be?
Taxable.
So even though I am giving you gift means without consideration or with consideration?
Without.
Still it is supply. Still it is
supply.
But then government had some courtesy towards employees. No. Everything should not become taxable. At least some concession we should provide. Concession they have given up to 50,000. So it will be taxable only if gift value exceeds 50,000. So if I give you 1 lakh rupees TV, no, whole 11 lakh rupees is taxable.
Yes.
Gift exceeding 50,000, pura taxable, 100% taxable. 45,000 TV I gave you.
Not
49,000. 49,999. 50,000. Not taxable. Because it is taxable only if it exceeds 50,000. And if it exceeds 50,000, whole amount taxable. Are you getting this? Sure, can I go ahead? So it may come in multiple choice question, no? Exceeding, not exceeding, less than 50, more than 50. So all options will be 50,000. The right option is exceeding. When is it taxable under Schedule 1? If gift value given by employer to employee exceeds 50,000. Am I clear?
Yes.
Should I go ahead?
Yes.
Then para 3 is principal to agent, agent to principal, principal to agent and agent to principal. Are you getting this? Hello? Principal to agent, agent to principal. Now you tell me, if you are my agent, you all are agents, I will manufacture goods and I will give it one quantity to each of you. Who will sell in the market? Agent will sell in the market. And agents are independent, you all are independent agents. So you sold goods, that means output GST is your liability.
Yes.
But who procured these goods? Principal. So ITC is available with whom?
Principal.
Are you getting this problem?
Yes.
Principal have ITC and liability is with
agent.
That means I will keep ITC with me, but there is no liability.
Yes.
ITC is there in my account. And in your account there is no ITC, but there will be
output
liability. This problem is there. How to handle this problem? How to handle this problem? When principal purchase this raw material or goods, he will book ITC. When I give this to agent, charge GST. But sir, I'm not selling it. It's okay, this is supply without consideration. Still it is considered as supply. Yes or no? I gave it to agent, that time only government is taking tax from me. Why is it, why government is taking tax from me? Because now agent is taking these goods. So agent will get ITC, and then who will sell in the market? Agent. So agent can set up that ITC and pay net amount of tax. Yes or no? Sir, tomorrow agent was not able to sell this product. Not able to sell this product in the market. He did all these things, but he is not able to sell this product. What agent will do? Agent will bring back these goods to? For agent also this is supply. Why? Because when he has taken goods from me, he has taken ITC.
Yes.
Now he is returning the goods. So he has to reverse ITC. So he will pay tax. And then these goods will come to principal. The moment agent pays tax, principal will get ITC. Yes or no? Again I am repeating, there are two transactions. Goods purchased by principal, principal took ITC. Okay? Given it to agent, principal will pay tax. Agent will take
ITC.
Yes or no? Then agent will sell it in the market. There will be output tax liability and he will set up ITC and he will pay net amount of tax value addition.
Yes.
Okay. Second situation, he is not able to sell in the market. He is not able to sell in the market. So he will return these goods to
principal.
At a time of returning these goods to principal, agent will pay tax. Agent should pay tax as if it is a supply. Okay. The moment agent paid tax, who will get credit? Principal will get the credit. Yes or no? So whether it is good supply by principal to agent or
agent
to principal, in both cases there is no consideration in all. I hope you are understanding. There is no consideration, but still it is supply. Still it is supply and still it is taxable. Purpose is to manage ITC. Purpose of bringing this law is to manage ITC. ITC has to be passed from principal to agent. Agent से ITC का जो amount है वो principal के पास जाना चाहिए, principal से agent के पास आना चाहिए. Hello? This smooth movement of ITC has to happen, therefore this clause was added. Am I clear? Sure? Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Last is importation of service. Importation of service is coming for second time now.
Yes.
How? 71B is also importation of service. Yes or no? 7(1)B is also importation of service, and 7(1)C clause schedule 1 para last para is also importation of service. So importation of service is coming two times in section 7. 7(1)B also have import of service, and 7(1)C also have import of service. So what is the difference between 7(1)B and 7(1)C? 7(1)B is import of service for a consideration, and 7(1)C import of service without consideration. Hello? But 7(1)B says import of service for a consideration whether or not in the course of business. 7(1)C says importation of service without consideration but in the course of business. Hello? So 7(1)B mein consideration hai, business nahi hai. 7(1)C mein consideration nahi hai but business hai. Hello? That means agar business aur consideration dono nahi hai to supply nahi hai. So import of service can be of four types. Totally import of service can be of four types. Okay, import of service. Please try to understand this. Import of service. There is a business as well as consideration. Both is there. Business as well as consideration. Which clause? 7(1)A. Supply? Is it supply? Yes. Taxable? Yes. Okay. Sir, business is not there, but consideration is there. So 7(1)B. Supply? Taxable. Okay. Sir, business is there, but consideration is not there. 7(1)C. Supply? Yes. Sir, business is also not there, consideration is also not there. Then this is not covered in any clause. So this is not a supply, not taxable. Example, I wanted to design my product or design my office. I took services from Dubai in the course of business for a consideration. Is it taxable? Yes. And import of service is taxable on reverse charge basis. That I told you earlier on. Okay. Second, can I go ahead? Okay. I took that architect services to design my house. So it is not in the course of business, but he charged consideration. Still it is taxable. 7(1)B. Yes or no? 7(1)C is not from any person, it is only from related person, only from related. So that supplier, no, outside India is my relative. Okay, so my brother, so I have to say my brother is the architect in Dubai. I called him and I said, brother, please come and design my office. He came and he designed. Do you think my brother will take consideration from me? No. So what is this? Supply of service, import of service without consideration but in the course of business, then it is taxable.
Yes.
I have to pay tax on that.
Yes.
My brother is an architect and I ask him to design my house without consideration.
No.
Hello? Are you getting this? So not taxable. Why not taxable?
No.
Not in the course of business. And
no.
You people use so many websites. Do you use websites?
Yes.
Google, Facebook, Instagram and other website that you people use. Do you pay consideration?
No.
No. Is it your business?
No.
No. So you don't use that website in the course of business. At the same time, you don't pay any? Is it a supply?
No.
Have you ever paid GST on that?
No.
No. Because it is neither in course of business nor for a consideration. Hello? So out of four possible combinations, three combinations are taxable, only one combination is not taxable in case of import of service. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Sure? Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Yeah? So, in this clause, what we have written, import of service, listen, from a related person, import of service from a related person, though related person is very important, or my establishment outside India. Establishment outside India means my branch office or head office is outside India. Yes or no? Alright, so I will teach you through examples now. We will go on and discuss all ICA questions, but here I allow me to finish law first. I am creating foundation first. Okay, next. In the course or furtherance of business. So what I told you here, consideration is missing, but business is there. Am I clear? Yeah, should I go ahead? So what has happened up to now is this. We are done with 7(1)A, we are done with 7(1)B, and we are also done with 7(1)C. Let us try to revise without looking into law. 7(1)A talks about supply includes.
Yes.
Supply includes what? All form of supply. Supply includes All form of supply. Some name you can give me: sale, transfer, barter, exchange, rent, license, disposal of goods or services or both. Am I clear?
Yes.
This is there. By a person for a
consideration
in the course or furtherance of business. So two important word we have to pick from 7-1A. Consideration and business. Am I clear?
Yes.
Okay. 7-1B says importation of service for a consideration, whether or not in the course or furtherance of business. That is in 7-1B. Only for importation of service. Exception to 7-1A.
Yes.
Okay. The third exception is given under section 7-1C. 7-1C is the deemed supply. It's not normal supply. It is completely weird kind of supply, because there is no consideration but still we have to pay tax. Don't you think it will hurt your emotions? Paisa mila nahi, fir bhi mujhe kya bharna hai? Tax. But that is anti-tax evasion mechanism, and the anti-tax evasion mechanism has to be there, otherwise people will evade tax.
Yes.
And then there are dual purpose. One is anti-tax evasion and one is smooth movement of ITC. Smooth movement of ITC should pass on from one person to another person smoothly, therefore this whole provision is created. So 7-1C is supply without consideration. Supply without
consideration.
And because it is a deemed supply, it need to have exhaustive list, proper list, and that list is given under schedule 1. That list is given in schedule 1. Schedule 1 talks about 4 items. P-A-R-I, PARI. P for permanent transfer or disposal of business asset, on which you have taken what? ITC. You have taken ITC. If you don't take ITC, then there is no problem. Okay. Second was agent to principal, principal to agent. So that is also taxable. To movement, to move ITC from one registered person to another registered person. Third, related party transaction. Whenever you sell goods to your related parties without any consideration, we are going to take tax on this. Yes or no? So related party or business, distinct person transactions are also covered. Branch transfer is also taxable. But one related party only enjoy benefit. Only one related party enjoy benefit up to 50,000, and that is employee. Services or goods given by employer to employee up to 50,000, it is not taxable. Exceeding 50,000, it is taxable. Only one benefit is there to employees. Yes or no? Because genuinely sometimes employees get some gift from employer. If I am Haldiram, obviously this is Diwali, I may give you 2,000, 5,000 Swiss to you all. Yes or no?
Yes.
5,000 rupees gift to all, 10,000 rupees gift to all, 20,000, 25,000, 40,000, 45,000, up to 50,000 government doesn't take it seriously. Yes or no? Exceeding 50,000 government takes it seriously, and then fully taxable. Okay?
Yes.
Only for employee. And then last one was I was importation of service from a related person or distinct person. From a related person or
distinct person.
Distinct person in the course or furtherance of business. Am I clear up to this?
Yes.
Okay. Sure?
Yes.
Pakka?
Yes.
We will do question now and then only we will move ahead. Okay?